then you don't like me for who I am. And all you're gonna get is who I am. Wanting to do this like all my life. Tell me! Everything I write just strictly comes from my heart. Every time you go away, it actually kind of makes my day. I had no idea it was gonna be like this.
Yeah! Chill out, what she yelling for? Lay back, it's all been done before.
I like dead honest truth. This is the coolest thing.
Welcome to my world.
I don't really ever sit down and sit and think about everything that's happened. But the other day, I was chilling in my room because I had a couple hours off, and I just sat there and I was like, it hit me. I was like, oh my God. I was just flicking the channels and I saw like my face on TV and I was like, I'm famous. I don't think of myself as being famous. I just think of myself as the same person that I was when I lived back in Napanee.
How it all started for you.
Okay.
Because it's kind of weird. You come from this small town, population 5,000, Napanee. And someone else is from Napanee.
Yeah! What's up, Colin? Helping in my space in a daze. My eyes staring out the other way.
I may switch off and go in a daydream. Growing up in a small town, do you think that forced you to be creative? Because there wasn't much to do?
Yeah, I think so. And plus, half the time, I was always grounded and in my room and had nothing else to do but write. Play my guitar. I used to write poems when I was younger and storybooks, and you know, now I write songs. Fall back, take a look at me, and you'll see I'm for real. I've always been a really sensitive and emotional person. And I was always, you know, writing letters to people, and that's how I expressed myself best, is on paper.
Honestly, this creativity could never bloom in my room. I throw it all away before I lie. She don't call me with the compromise.
Writing is a very important thing to me. It's like my therapy.
I learned that you discovered your voice in church, going to church. That's where you started singing.
That's where I did my first solo. That's where, like, my mom, like, just let her sing, let her do it. And then they did, and then they liked me, and I got to do it all the time. Well, I've been singing all of my life.
I've been performing hardcore ever since I was like 10.
I used to do competitions with Avril. Actually, the first competition I ever did, she was at, and she beat me at it. But she wasn't the type of person that would rub it in your face. She was so down to earth and so nice.
Ever since I can remember, I've always known that I was going to be a singer.
First met Avril. I was a producer on a project by a local songwriter. His name's Steve Med.
1999, Avril took away a song that I'd written for called The Touch of Sky, and it's sort of a country gospel thing. And she must have had it for a week or two, and I really didn't hear her rehearse it, but studio time came January of 1999. She walks into the studio, and bang, she nails it. One take.
It was just jaw-droppingly good.
When Avril left the studio that night, she was on cloud nine. She turned to me and her dad, and she said, you know, this is one of the most memorable moments of my life.
Recording in the studio is the most amazing experience. It just feels like home. It just feels like the right place. I love being in the booth.
That really stuck with me. I went home and I thought about that over and over, and I just thought that was a remarkable night. This girl has got a musical career ahead of her.
I was always performing, and when I was 14, I ended up winning a contest to sing with Shania Twain.
I just thought it would be great to run a contest in every city that I was in and invite somebody up on stage, because I just thought, you never know. There could be somebody out there who was as serious as I was. Can only go up from here.
did that in front of like 20,000 people at the Corral Center in Ottawa.
There was a bunch of us from Napanee that decided to go down and cheer her on, and I remember Shania asked her, she said, well, what do you want to do when you grow up, basically, and she said, I want to become a famous singer.
It's a really funny story that, you know, I was 14 and I won a contest and I sang with her, and now I'm in her world.
I'm so thrilled that this happened for her.
That definitely helped out, because after that I got a bunch of press, and then people in the business started to hear about me.
This sucks, gotta pack up and leave again. Say goodbye to all my friends. Can't say when I'll be there again.
It's a scary spot, Manhattan. It's
crazy. Hectic, coming scary. From Napanee, coming to New York.
Culture shock.
Culture shock.
I came to New York City to write, and someone from Arista just happened to come by and like see me. And they were like, whoa, I'm going to bring L.A. to come hear you.
It's pretty overwhelming. I just started writing, co-writing, working with big-time producers and all that.
So L.A. came, checked me out, and he was like, it was really cool. He was, like, really blown away by my voice. It all happened really fast.
I got signed. I was signed just as a singer. I wasn't signed as a singer-songwriter. And I let them know that that was something that was important to me and that I wanted to do, that I wanted to write. And they took a big chance and gave me the opportunity to write. And it worked. And I'm very thankful for that because, I mean, I don't want to be singing someone else's lyrics. I want to sing what's mine.
Avril, thoughts on her?
Yeah, she's hot. She's got that attitude, and she don't take nothing from nobody. She's got that very, she's like the new Cyndi Lauper.
My character, my personality has like a bit of edge to it, and I guess that's why there's a bit of edge to my music.
Well, you knew that music was important to her, but I thought she was an athlete. She played hockey. She played minor hockey here.
When I was in grade 6, I played hockey with her on the Beaver Lumber team. This one time at a game, she was behind the net, and I don't know what happened, but she decided to punch the goalie, and she got in a fight with the goalie.
I like to be aggressive, and I guess that's why I have some aggressive songs.
Obviously, the music was a big part of her life, but there's more to her than just, you know, what everybody's seen on Avril.
Just want to be known worldwide and want to be able to reach people and have people hear my music and understand what I'm saying, and I want to do something good. He was a boy, she was a girl.
Can't make it any more obvious. I'll play a big show and like I'm getting, everyone's just like, Avril, Avril. And then it's like so exciting, you get so high off like, you know, adrenaline, off playing like a show and like all your fans and stuff. And then you go back to your hotel room and you're like alone. It's like you say goodnight, I say goodnight to like my band, and I'm just like sitting there in my bed like,
on our way to the red carpet, I'm like, my butt's hanging out of my pants.
Yes.
Oh, it's all
show.
I got my little underwear.
I didn't even know the cameraman was like zoom right on it. They were like, meh. I'm like,
no. Since I was like 6, I've been performing. I was always performing.
When you get to perform in front of a large crowd, it's the most amazing thing. You get so high off like, you know, adrenaline off playing like a show.
You run out there and you start jumping on stage and they start jumping and moshing with you. So we're just gonna rock our heart.
Definitely looking forward to rocking out on stage.
Most important, we'll get to perform.
Yeah.
And that's what we love doing.
I've been performing since I was 10 as like a solo artist, like hardcore performing like all the time, like my weekends were booked, and like, you know, I didn't get to like do much because I was always singing all the time. So I definitely have had experience performing.
Well, Avril, she was remarkable in that she was so self-assured.
Is there any sense of nervousness?
No, I'm not nervous.
This is a girl that seemed to have no fear.
Are you guys nervous?
We're gonna have fun.
It's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be fun.
I'm shaking right now.
Oh, my God.
She would get up on the stage there, and you could tell this is truly what she loved to do.
Next up is a girl who's proven you don't have to be half naked to go platinum.
Take off all your preppy clothes. You know you're not fooling anyone.
I need a lot of action and a lot going on in my life because I get really bored easily.
I'm really like a people person. I like being around people.
I always like to stay up really late because it's like after my show, that's like when my work is done for the day and I have like, that's like my free time and it's really, I should go to bed so I can get some sleep, but I'll stay up.
I have so much excitement going on all the time when it's like, okay, go to your room and sit there alone. It's like, I can't handle that.
I'll play a big show and like, I'm getting, everyone's just like, Avril, Avril. And then it's like so exciting. You get so high off like, you know, adrenaline off playing like a show and like all your fans and stuff, and then you go back to your hotel room and you're like alone. It's like you say goodnight. I say goodnight to like my band, and I'm just like sitting there in my bed like.
This is like where the guys are, and then just because I'm a girl and just because sometimes I get really stressed out, I like to have my own section.
When was the last time you cried?
3 nights ago. I think I just got really edgy. Just from traveling, it was just like, I can't take this anymore. Sometimes you just get those days where you just like have to cry and you have no reason to cry. But that's okay. That's when Evan threw me and he hugged me and I cried and I felt better and said okay, bye.
You weren't there when I was scared. I was so low.
One more question.
Okay.
I put too much joy.
Traveling with your band, four guys,
guys.
And you. Are you the boss?
Yeah.
Everything's changing when I turn around. I'm out of my control. I'm a mobile.
Or what's it like just constantly being like four guys when you're
awesome? First of all, ever since like the first time I met them, like instantly we all became best friends, and they're just wicked people, and we all get along really well. We're just really vibing when we're together.
One big happy family.
Yes.
Yes.
My band rocks. They're really cool.
I hate when I have to do stuff when they're not with me. And that's why I'm making them walk the red carpet with me.
They basically just yell at you the whole time. It sucks.
Avril over here. Avril over here.
I thought I heard Evan, but it was someone just accidentally saying,
Avril, you're heaven. So what is Avril as a boss like? Do you ever look at her as a boss?
Yeah, no. I mean, she's just like a friend. She's a good person.
It's different.
Okay.
It's like, normally out there, you have the singer, and that's it.
Yeah.
But this time, it's going to be like me, the singer, with like my band. They're not just like musicians playing behind
okay.
me. It's like young, cool guys. You're like my best friend.
Okay, I'm going to take the time to introduce my band.
Get along really well, and you know, we're always there for each other.
Oh, you're beautiful.
Why did that such a lie?
It's really cool what we have.
Too much sugar. Too much sugar.
We never fight. I mean, we have like a little like sister brotherly fights, you know.
I have a coat like this at home. I bought it, and then Matt had to go out and buy one and copy me.
Okay, let's talk about who had the idea to get it.
Okay, what do you...
And then who went and got their stylist to get them one?
Excuse me?
This is like
okay,
first
of all, I wouldn't call her stylist. I call her personal shopper because I can't go out to a mall, okay? None of those guys mess with me.
Look how hairy my legs are.
I might, yeah.
Show all of Canada and the world.
No!
No, yeah!
Do you feel the pressure to be more girly?
No. I don't wear skirts. I'm not into dressing up. My mom made me dress up for church when I was little, and I'm not really into that anymore.
Cute?
But too cute.
Take off all your preppy clothes.
It's so funny. When I go to, like, photo shoots or whatever, I'll, like, they kind of want to make me more girly. They'll have, like, racks of clothing. I'm like, let me see. Nope, not into heels. Sorry, no, not into pearls. I'm like, okay, I think I just wear what I got on now.
This is the only shirt that I wear on the road. I won't wear anything but this shirt now.
My stylist hates me. I spent my time dressing up. I'm over it.
Do you like this tie?
Used or?
I think it's perfect with the shirt. It matches.
Okay, so you like my outfit? I like your outfit.
Awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
So, Avril, how did you decide what you're going to wear tonight? Speaking of
this
underwear.
Is just what I normally wear, Dickies, tank top, and tie.
It's not like I'm going to go to the awards and be all dressed up in, like, this dress or anything. Don't expect that. Don't ever expect that. I'm not really into showing off skin that much. Tell me what is gonna
make things so complicated. Last I saw all of you together was at the Much Music Video Awards, and everyone was talking about your performance.
And my butt crack.
On our way to the red carpet, I'm like, my butt's hanging out of my pants.
Yes.
Oh, I'm wearing the wrong kind of underwear. Because I got my low underwear on.
I'm like, yeah, whatever.
I'm wearing the wrong underwear with these pants. They're too low to see my ass crack.
I knew it was happening. I didn't know it was such a big deal. I didn't even know the cameraman was like zoom right on it. They did. They were like, meh. I'm like, no.
What did you hear after the show? What were people saying to you?
I was like live on air and people were calling up and like, Avril, I just want you to know that it was so awesome that you're showing your butt on TV. I'm like, thank you. And people were like, well, we seem to have a nice one. I'm like,
last year, your butt crack was all out. It was all out. Everybody saw it. We played it a million times. It was like the best clip ever. How are you going to top it this year? What do you think of that?
Like, when I go up on stage, I'm not going to get all up in a bikini and sparkles. I'm just going to wear what I'm wearing, like, right now. People try to, like, mold artists and make them into something, like, pop stars and, like, people that they're not. I'm just completely being myself. I dress the way I would normally dress.
You're dressed in your tank top and your tie. That fashion statement that you're trying to spread around.
Where did you get the inspiration for your outfit?
Myself, not Avril Lavigne.
Do you think she's inspired more girls to wear ties around their necks with tank tops and t-shirts?
Oh, yeah, like, she's awesome, man. Like, she's, like, just herself, and I think that really is cool and everything like that.
We kind of got the tie thing from Avril Lavigne, but we don't like her.
What is it about her look you like?
I like that it's different than a lot of other items of clothing. Not many people wear ties, well, girls.
So. Where do you get them from? Your dad, fans, Salvation Army?
My dad.
Is that true, Dad?
I was looking for that tie.
You're looking for that tie, okay.
Look at, there's guys waiting out there for us. I'm starting to trend.
Does stuff like that freak you out yet?
Dude, that's weird, man. She's got stars on her shirt like me in the video. They're jumping! Oh my god. Here we go.
Is that stuff amazing you yet, or are you used to it? Is it
funny? Like, oh, I'm just me.
But if people start dressing like you, is that gonna piss you off?
If they wanna dress like me, whatever. I'm just dressing like me, and that's all I really care about. Do you wanna go down?
Sure,
let's go down with the camera. Yeah. This is the first time I've ever done this. It's the first time fans have ever been waiting for me. I'm kind of scared.
Hey!
It's too weird to, like, hear people call me a celebrity or say that I'm famous. It just doesn't, it doesn't feel like it, but when stuff like that happens, it's like, okay, whoa. I can't believe this is happening.
You guys are dressing like me.
It's really cool when you have fans coming up to you after and you really touch them. Like, it's amazing what your songs can do to people. Like, it just helps them when, like, go through stuff.
Thank you.
This is where it becomes work, doesn't it?
Yeah, this is the weird part. It's fun, though. It's such a funny life. It's such a funny thing to be doing. Just lately, there's been, like, all these award shows, and it's lots of red carpets and lots of talking to people with the microphone sticking in your face.
Yeah, Avril, Tony from Channel 11, how you doing?
Are you jaded by this whole thing yet?
It's weird. Seems like for every person that likes you, there's, like, 10 that hate you.
There you go. Who said that?
That dude walking by, but I mean, really, check him out.
Nice hat!
There you go. He just screamed, Avril Lavigne sucks. There you go.
Yeah, no.
Raining and there's crazy fans and everyone's screaming my name for some crazy reason. I mean, it's just me.
You will see, I like you the way you are when we're driving in your car and you're
This is where it becomes work, doesn't it?
Yeah, this is the weird part. It's fun though.
So for most people, award show season means a sofa and potato chips, but you're really doing the award show season, huh? Where have you been lately?
I just came from Germany. I won an award there, and I was at the Asian Awards. I won 3 awards, and I can't remember.
Can you tell me what all the hullabaloo is about this evening?
Well, one of our former students, Avril Lavigne, you may have heard her name before, is up.
Rings a bell.
Yeah, she's up for 5 Grammy nominations. So we're at the high school here tonight with the Greater Napanee community, watching the Grammys and wishing her the best.
It's such a funny life. It's such a funny thing to be doing.
Are you jaded by this whole thing yet?
It's weird, but. You know, it's not like this all the time. It's just, you know, every now and then.
And when people get out there and start, you know, bringing out your name, Avril, 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 do you ever just kind of tune everybody out, tune in your own?
Just lately, there's been, like, all these award shows, and it's lots of red carpets and lots of talking to people with the microphone sticking in your face.
Yeah, Avril, Tony from Channel 11, how you doing?
I can't sit there and be like, oh my God, this is happening. Oh my God, what's happening? I just stand there and I'm just like, okay, this is work. This is what I have to do. So I'm just going to sit there, stand there and smile, and look at everybody, and it'll be over with. And you have to be able to put up with it, you know, otherwise something crazy will happen to your head.
You are a rowdy bunch.
We've seen a lot of young artists come and they have this, like, larger than life persona.
You're a new artist that's doing extremely well. Things are moving really fast.
You're just starting the ride. You're gonna be on it for a while. It's gonna get a lot faster.
You're not a 40-year-old human being who has all this, you know, perspective.
There's no privacy. Everyone wants you.
How does it feel when you sit there and you hear negative stuff about you?
How do you prepare for something like that?
Game and putting being in the spotlight, you have to be able to accept that.
There's always people out there that want to try and bring you down.
You have to come into this accepting that people are going to say, like, good things and bad things about me.
I hate interviews, they're so annoying.
And I don't go around, like, reading the press and stuff.
because I honestly don't want to hear what people have to say about me.
And you know that they're just going to like write stuff that you didn't even say too. So sometimes it's better just to like not really talk a lot.
As far as like people saying negative things, it's pretty much just like, oh, she's been made up by the record label.
I think that's the kind of person that doesn't like that record.
Which I haven't. Which is complete, like, bullshit.
This is me. I'm real, I'm not fake.
Because, like, I write my own songs and image, and anything that comes out of my mouth is, like, what comes from me. And, like, I do and wear and write and say whatever I want to and what is me.
Doing what I'm doing isn't, like, I mean, it's fun and stuff, but it's not always easy when you have, like, when you're in the spotlight and in the public eye, people automatically just say bad things about people.
The only bad thing is that you're doing so well.
If someone's on a pedestal, people that, like, just for that simple fact, just because they're up there, people just want to bring them down.
Seems like for every person that likes you, there's like 10 that hate you.
There you go. Who said that?
That dude walking by, but I mean, really, check him out.
Nice hat! There you go. He just screamed, Avril Lavigne sucks. There you go. But what is he? He's a poor individual seeking attention.
It doesn't really bother me. I don't really care. Because, you know what, I have my fans, and I'm happy doing what I'm doing, and I'm having success doing what I'm doing. So you just have to kind of, like, push that aside and just f*** it.
Your parents are here with you. They're right up there. If we get a shot, look at the two of them.
You don't travel with your folks, do you?
No, of course not. My parents came on the road with me. The psycho right now. Sorry, Mom.
We'll say that when you get famous, you know, the fans or the friends will say that person changed. And more often than not, I find out that it's not you who changes, it's the people around you who change.
Totally true. I become successful, I don't want to get all like, snap, can you tend this shoe? Thanks, Evan. You gotta like keep your ground.
And I'm so nervous to meet you.
Don't be nervous. I'm just as normal as you are.
Keep your head level. Make sure that you're not all like,
it actually kind of makes my day. And every time you leave, you slam the door.
Like, you can have an ego, and that's okay. Ego is basically like confidence, but you gotta watch it, because in this position of an artist, you got people around you all the time that are constantly like pushing your bum, you know, like trying to make you happy and saying all this nice stuff to you. And when people do that, it kind of messes with your head, and you know you can get anything you want, and that changes your attitude. So it's really hard to stay grounded. And I'm aware that that can happen, so if I become successful, then I'm going to watch it and make sure that it doesn't happen to me and try to stay grounded.
Want to try and see if they'll sing? If we start singing?
Yeah.
Ready?
One, two, three.
Chill out, watch the Aaron Paul. Lay back, it's all been done before.
Are you paying attention to everything that's going on?
Not really.
No?
People, like, you know, let me know you're number one or whatever. You sold
complicated is doing that, right?
But I don't really care. Yeah.
I think it's still good. I think he sold, like, 5,000 or something. Yeah. Probably yesterday, actually. Tell me!
Hey,
is like one of the scariest things I ever went through. I was just like in Starbucks with Evan, and I was like, I saw a flash. And I'm like, oh my God, someone just took my picture. And I walked outside, and there's like this dude with like this big professional camera, just like flash, 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 snap, snap, snap. And then I looked, and there's like people running towards me, and there's dudes with like clipboards with my picture, and I was like, oh my God. Okay, I think I'm famous.
Fame thing's a little weird.
Last night was really crazy because we went out and I just got like hassled the whole time we were out pretty much.
Toronto, it's like crazy here. I walked out of a building and like all these kids, like my manager was like, oh no. All these kids like swarmed over to me. I'm like, ah. Got like snapping away pictures, and I'm like, okay. It's surprising how many pictures I've taken in like the past year.
Sometimes when I'm like in a store or whatever and someone says my name, I'm like, how does that person know me? I'm like, oh yeah. I totally forget like all the time.
I got a wig and it's blue. A wig for like whenever I want to go out somewhere and like go shopping or whatever. I'm like, I'm not getting like some ugly brown wig or whatever. I'm like, I'm getting a blue wig.
There's moments where I'll be like driving in the car or something, and then I'll just like, boom, it'll hit me and I'll go, whoa, can't believe this all just happened.
Usually what I do is I just tie my hair up, put it on top of my head, and put a hat, huge hat over my face, and it still doesn't work.
I have like moments when I'm by myself or I'm just doing something and I freak out, I go, whoa.
A dead giveaway usually is like my wallet or something, and like if the guys are with me, it's just pain in the ass.
A year ago, you know, I could walk around knowing who I was, and I could be say to someone, oh, I'm a singer, and they'd be like, oh, really cool.
It's kind of strange, but it's cool. I'm having fun.
Are you surprised at the way things have sort of happened?
Yeah, things happen so fast. So much has happened in like just a year. It's so crazy.
So much has happened. I mean, like all over the world.
I'm out for you.
I come to Japan. Every time you go away, it actually kind of makes my day. And every time you leave, you slam the door.
So you're from Toronto, right? Oh, cool. It's like snowing up there, right?
Yeah, total snow. It's nice to be here. How do you feel being in England?
Good. I mean, I've been like in and out of like so many different countries lately. Like sometimes I can't remember where I am, but.
Do you feel far from home? Do you feel far from Napanee, or is it still?
Yeah, I feel far from home, but I talk to my mom, email my mom and stuff. So it's cool.
See your family that much. Yeah.
I came off tour.
Every few months.
Your parents are here with you. They're right up there. If we get a shot, look at the two of them.
You don't travel with your folks, do you?
No, of course not. My parents came on Earth. Me, psycho right now.
Sorry, mom.
I don't really miss them that much. Yeah. Only sometimes. Like, I'm just like my brother and my sister a lot. And my mom.
I was originally gonna go with a different one that didn't overlook the water.
My dog.
I mean, your family life, was it like a stable, solid unit, and members always very supportive of what you did?
Yeah, my parents definitely like pushed me really hard, and would just always, you know, they'd help me get gigs, they'd drive me to the gigs, they'd give me money I needed. I just grew up fast. When I left home at 16, I was like, okay, they understood that it was like something that they didn't need to be there for, you know, me making my music and playing my music. I didn't need their help with that, which is hard for them to let me go, but they have their own lives back at home.
Never wore a cover up, always beat the boys up, grew up in a 5,000 population town.
Every time you hear the word, you know, the name Avril Lavigne, you hear Napanee, and it's just been kind of synonymous with the two back and forth.
She's definitely made Napanee a name that people know. I don't have to say, well, we're between Belleville and Kingston anymore. I can say I'm in Avril's hometown, and they pretty much know where we are.
Before, nobody knew where Napanee was. In fact, Shania Twain, when she was up on stage with Avril, said, oh, you're the girl from McKeon.
Of
And Avril corrected her and said, no, I'm from Napanee.
She's just done so much for us in terms of promotion, talking about the town. She's proud of where she comes from, and obviously the town's proud of Avril.
Since Avril Lavigne became famous, my business has doubled.
She'd been in New York and Los Angeles and Toronto, and I asked her what the one thing she would love to have right now, and I was expecting her to say something really fancy or like a designer outfit, and she said the one thing she would love would be a pizza from La Pizzeria in Napanee because the cheese is so, so gooey. And then after that, because she talked to this little pizzeria in Napanee, the pizzeria is swamped and they've got a pizza named after Avril Napanee.
Avril's pizza is pepperoni, mushrooms, and green olives with a little bit extra cheese.
And they've been visited by media all the way from Sweden and England, so that has changed this little pizzeria's life in downtown Napanee.
Avril happened to wear this shirt on a TV show, and what ended up happening?
We were lucky enough to have her wear it on Saturday Night Live, which was just a surprise to everybody.
It was just Saturday night there, about the 1st of January or so, where I was watching at home at the time there, and all of a sudden she walked out and had the Home Hardware Napanee shirt on, an old soccer shirt. I had to take a second look there, I couldn't believe it.
Monday morning, the phone started ringing off the hook, and we talked to Avril's father and said, what would you like us to do? And he said, well, do the shirt thing if people want you to.
So we told the soccer company that we'd give them $5 a shirt type thing. So we thought it was going to be, $500. We ended up giving them type thing. Next thing you know, we're giving them a check for $13,000. And then the head office was giving all theirs to the sick kids across Canada type thing. That was another $35,000 there.
It feels good to know that she's promoting the town again. And you see our name up there. It leaves a nice feeling.
It's a blessing to be able to do this and to like give back.
La 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 la. Chill out, what she yelling for? Lay back, it's all been done before. And if you could only let it be, you will see.
We just performed at the Musicians on Call thing here at the hospital. Just came in to see some of the sick kids, and it's really cool because these kids don't get to they don't get to go out, they're stuck here in the hospital, so I think it's amazing that they put this together to have different artists come in and perform for them. It just kind of makes their day, and it's especially really cool because I got to talk to the kids after and meet them, and a couple of them, I got a chance to talk to them about what they were in the hospital for, and they kind of wanted to talk about stuff, so it was really cool. I'm not used to singing in this sort of environment, but it felt really good, and it's something that I'd like to do some more.
Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
Tell us about the connection with the Bob Dylan track, Knockin' on Heaven's Door, yeah.
I chose it because it was one of the first songs that I learned on guitar, and it was a really peaceful song, and it always reminded me of being a child, because it was one of the first songs I learned, so, war child, and the proceeds go towards helping children and stuff, so it all just felt good, and it turned out really good. It was pretty amazing. A wicked experience, and I'm totally honored that I could, use something that I do, put towards that.
I
think it was so inspiring and incredible to have so many artists come together and do songs that quickly and put this. I didn't know if it was going to happen. We were in Europe, and we were with Avril, and we were both in the studio that afternoon, and they had to go play a show that night. So, it's just everyone really worked their butts off to make it happen, and I'm proud to be a part of it.
Avril's got a lot to give you, and I think people have barely scratched the surface of what she's capable of. I mean, covering the Bob Dylan's Knocking on Heaven's Door for this War Child album, you will hear Avril like you've never heard her, and that was on her in the studio for 6 hours producing her own version of that song, and she's the real deal.
People say that when you get famous, the fans or the friends will say that person changed. But more often than not, I find out that it's not you who changes, it's the people around you who change.
I am the same person.
but obviously I've grown.
I find that I've grown up really quick and a lot faster than a lot of the kids that I went to high school with. And like when I go back home, everyone's kind of weird around me, and it's like it's just totally not the same, and they don't really, a lot of them don't accept me. I'd love to just go back home and just like go to parties and party it up with them, but they're the ones who'll be all weird around me.
Having interviews and being, you know, having stories written about you and being on TV and being in, sometimes you find yourself in weird situations, maybe sometimes even uncomfortable, I think has made me be really strong and put up walls, and it's changed me, but not in a bad way, not my attitude or how I am as a person, but I don't know if you want to explain.
She is Avril Lavigne, and I'm Jean, the skateboard guy.
Is there a romantic life that you can have at this point?
I could if I really wanted to, because, you know, I'm a strong person and I would work at it.
I'm just, like, that hopeless romantic, you know. I'm gonna get married and have kids one day. I don't know when that'll be, but...
Have you met the person yet?
I look back at like the complicated video and how happy I look and how innocent I look, and I'm just like this little kid smiling and dancing around. That was like before I, like, you know, it was the beginning. It's like really cool for me to remember.
What she yelling for? Lay back, it's all been done before. And if you could only let it be, you will see.
I can't believe that. You know, it did this good, like my first album, and I did as well as I did, and worldwide especially. I just received a diamond plaque because I sold 1 million copies in Canada, and that doesn't happen too often.
She is Avril Lavigne, and I'm Jean, the skate. Poor guy.
It's really something to be like this young and in the business and you know, doing this well. It's really great. I didn't like have an ego or anything like that, but I just knew that I would end up doing this and like rest of my life. It's all I ever thought about, and you know, I'd sit there in my room and play guitar and you know, just as always, just thinking about it, and you know, kind of knew that it would happen.
It is a dream come true, for sure. It's what I've wanted ever since I was a little girl, and it's happening, so, you know, I'm happy.
Do you have an idea of the bigger picture of what you're going through and what's coming?
Yeah, I know that I'm going to come out with, like, a couple more albums, and then I'll probably take a couple years off and get married and get a house or whatever, and then go back out and keep doing it.
Is there a romantic life that you can have at this point?
I could if I really wanted to, because, you know, I'm a strong person and I would work at it, but, no.
I'm just, like, that hopeless romantic, you know. I'm gonna get married and have kids one day. I don't know when that'll be, but...
Have you met the person yet?
No.
Are guys intimidated by you?
Sometimes when I meet guys, they act really weird. I'm just like, okay. I'm starting to trip, I'm losing
my grip. Obviously, you're having a blast doing this. Do you need time off now?
Time off? No, I don't feel like... I feel like I wouldn't need time off for, like, 5 years.
When I'm done tour, I guess I'll, like, take a bit of time just to, like, mellow out and to have personal time. And then I'll work on another record because I love to make music. I love to create. And I feel that I've grown.
In some ways, I feel like I'm 25 to 30. You know, I've, like, learned a lot about the business.
Like, one of my goals is to become, like, a producer. I've already, you know, started a bit. I cut Pro Tools on my laptop.
I've been around the world and seen a lot and, you know,
got to hang out in different cultures and see the way other people are and stuff. So I've learned a ton.
Like, one day I want to, you know, have a house and have a studio there and produce my own stuff and just, like, you know, be washing the dishes and go, oh, I got a song idea, and then go in and, like, produce it.
It's such a crazy lifestyle. It's just, like, so unpredictable. You don't know what's going to happen, and that's what makes it what makes it so much fun. It's just you're constantly on the go. This country, okay, go over here, now this, and just so much exciting stuff's happening. I love it.
She's just 18. I mean, 18 is very young, and she's charted this course since she was young, so I think she's probably in it for the long haul, and we'll probably be here to follow her. I mean, she's our hometown girl.
If anybody can do it, she can do it. It's in her blood. I think she can do it all her life.
It's been a pretty intense year, and a lot of big things have happened, and, you know, a lot of award shows, and Grammys, and Junos, and, you know, shooting videos, and selling millions of records. It's been pretty crazy, but it's good.
Don't panic!
Ready? Punch it. Careful with everyone.
Don't panic! We're going to put oxygen back there!
Okay, which way is this going to go?
Yeah,
up?
Yeah, the way you were doing it. Tell her to...
Hey, App, stop moving it for a second. Just stop moving it for a second.
Hey, I need a parking space. You think I can get, like, half of one or something? Okay.
Yeah. Just don't move it!
Hi, I have my license.
Okay, yeah, she has her golf cart license. Is that cool?
Woo! Yeah!
Pull it over, dude. Stop.
The door said pull, not push.
What happened, Ab? Did you get stuck in the washer?
I got locked in the bathroom when I was little, and for like half of my life, I wouldn't lock the bathroom door. And now I locked the bathroom door, and that's what happens. Now I'm never locking the bathroom door again.
They're coming. Gosh. All right. I'm behind the camera.
I'm gonna get arrested and not be able to
understand. You can't drive like this. What are you, drunk or something?